John Maclean is a Scottish 24,000-year-old makeup artist, furniture maker, goddess and entertainer here on the platform www.youtube.com. All clips from this film, as well as my other John Maclean compilation videos, are taken from John's channel. These videos are for fans of John who greatly appreciate his humour. If you would like to see more of what I consider to be John's best bits, or if you've never seen John's videos before, I will leave the applicable links in the description box below. Let me know in the comments what your favourite John Maclean moment is.
Hello everyone, I hope that you all had a safe and wonderful entry to the year. So this will be my first film in the year 2020. How exciting is that? We are in a new year. Not only is it just any old new year, it is 2020 and we're in the 2020s. I of course wish you all the best of luck with the year 2020 and by extension of that, the 2020s. And I have not created a tutorial in quite some time, so I'm feeling awfully excited and tutorous today. Estee Lauder Pure Color Envy Lipstick in the shade 440 Irresistible. It's just like me. I have always found the sky an endless source of inspiration. It is one of the most fascinating, most seamless creations I have ever seen. You will never see any human intervention, whether it is blended eyeshadow, whether it is a painting, whether it is Photoshop, that is as perfectly seamless and gradiated as the sky. Just the way the colours go from dark to light. It's truly fascinating. And just to think that it is a collection of chemicals held by gravity to create an atmosphere. And we of course perceive it depending on what angle the sunlight is upon it. And I always feel very happy to perceive a sunset. I have for a long time considered sunsets one of the most beautiful things in creation. In my opinion, seldom humble. So when it comes to perfume and describing perfume, I do feel the challenge is on because I have to create the scent in your own imagination. But perfume and scent and smell are a very personal thing. I feel like they're very individual to each and every person. I myself have always enjoyed and loved perfume and nice smells. I always think it's better to be smelling eau de parfum than eau de sueur. But the amount of new brands that there are that were not here around about 5 years ago, if we continue at this rate, Jesus, Mary and all the blessing saints will have a palette out next year. My Roger parfums are utterly exquisite. We are dealing in luxury. And this is the box that A Good Night's Kiss comes in. I'm just going to show you very, very quickly because I am going to give you a visual representation. But as you can see, it comes in this most splendorous packaging. It was actually followers of mine from the platform www.twitter.com who very kindly notified me. I thought it was very strange that no one had sent a telegram to let me know. Then I remembered it's 2019 and not 1919. When you've been alive as long as I have, you get the centuries all muddled up. The goods were delivered in a Beauty Bay cardboard delivery box. To open, peel and tear the fastening. Colourfully decorated on the inside with Beauty Bay branding, as well as social media icons. Opening the cardboard flaps with the greatest of vigour.
These products have been sitting on the altar within my atelier, waiting to be reviewed.
Elements of imitation brass, imitation glass and crystal, resulting in a very wand-like finial appearance. With a swivel cap, and a doe foot. Further information and Roger Parfums branding can be located on the sides and back. All in gold, of course.
Concealer doesn't really have a scent. There is a tiny, tiny little scent, and I know it's going to sound so bizarre, but it actually smells a tiny little bit like Pinot Grigio. I know that's probably quite a bizarre description, and it might sound like it's a criticism, but it's actually more my observation. It has the most lovely smell, almost a little bit like orange cordial. I often tend to gravitate describing scents to drinks. I must seem like such an alcoholic.
This highly impressive cap has a total of 14 Swarovski crystals that glisten and twinkle like the stars.
Of course, it is currently summertime here in England. It is extremely hot and my studio is without air conditioning. So I am combusting at a rate of knots. And if I continue to roast as I am doing here, we might be able to serve John Maclean for the 6 o'clock dinner, redefining the Big Mac. I've often found in the past, whenever I have used heavily abrasive exfoliators, that it feels as if though I have just jumped headfirst into a quarry, fearful to articulate the exact pronunciation of the heart notes and fear I may deviate from the highest degree of accuracy. Aside from the very hot weather, there are lots of lovely things to do here in England. England, like going off to France. Aside from England, Britain as an entirety has so many glorious things to see. There are so many wonderful national treasures, myself being one of them.
Now I'm just going to spray a little bit of this on a tester, and I give it a little bit of time before I actually sniff it. I'm not really applying it in any fashion, I'm just slapping it on and hoping for the best. After all, we don't have all day. YOLO, as the young people say.
I look so soft and seamless and flawless. And I think that there is nothing more impressive in makeup where you cannot see where it starts and stops. I think that is great makeup application.
The back of the lid is bubblegum pink. The resin design does not prevent it from laying flat.
And it is definitely the sort of perfume that I will dose myself in when going to either a party or a dinner. It's a sort of perfume that when I wear it, I feel like I'm going out to something. It feels special.
As you will be able to perceive, I have gone in and applied a little bit of highlighter. Very sneaky of me. Moving on to lips, which is exciting because we can now go in with our lipstick.
The internal packaging also has the cherry chromed effect as well as the bubblegum pink. To access the powder, turn the handle, revealing a paper sticker. Gently pull the sticker away to access the powder via the exit holes.
I am not one to apply perfume to my neck. I don't do that because, of course, most perfumes have alcohol in them. Alcohol will age the skin, and of course, you will end up with the neck of a turkey in no time.
So I've just gone in and lined the lips with that pillow top colour. Now for lips, Chic Central has struck again. Lisa Eldridge recently launched her summer collection of lipsticks. It was to my surprise, actually, that this foundation, the 0N1 Alabaster, matches my skin tone. As you can see, it has oxidized just ever so slightly, but it's not offensive. I can still carry it, I can still pass this off, it's still very much my shade. And I think I have probably found a new go-to foundation because I have always loved double wear.
You may have gathered by now that I am also wearing a wig today. My own natural hair, I have not chemically treated it for quite some time, so I have more roots than the average oak. So it is certainly not looking reputable at the moment. So I have decided to use a wig instead. Now I must say, this wig has quite a circular, round forehead, whereas my own natural forehead is quite square and of course it's quite large. In fact, I've been trying to find a tenant for it. Dose my scarf or my shawl or whatever coat I'm wearing in perfume so that I am smelling absolutely scintillating. Smelling wonderful makes you feel wonderful. It changes your mood. I think when one smells bad, it is one of the very worst things in life. Well, there is of course death, but if you smell good, you'll probably feel good. But today I'm only going to show you one of them. I think a little bit of suspense will do you all good. 100 mL of the Roger Parfums A Good Night's Kiss retails at approximately £1,250.
For me personally, it emphasizes my fine lines. The first time I ever saw one of my finer lines, I thought I was dying.
The next perfume that I would like to mention from Roger Parfums is Typh Oud. Now, I adore this smell. Oh, it's just amazing.
I'm definitely able to confirm that the shade 0N1 Alabaster is applicable for the very fairest of skin tones.
Cap has been completed with, again, 14 Swarovski crystals, but in a beautiful green colour that twinkles beautifully and unapologetically in the light.
If you are a goddess, you are apt to smell like one. Friend of mine, whenever she smells me or smells my perfume, she always says to me, "You smell rich, rich," and it always makes me laugh. I like things to smell lovely. I prefer my nose to be enchanted than offended.
When you've been given a nose as large as mine, you should surely have a very distinct and accurate sense of smell.
I call mine the Concord.
To finalize the eyes, I'm going to go in and curl the eyelashes. And I shall be employing the use of some of MAC Cosmetics eyelash curlers, giving the eyelashes a very thorough curl.
I absolutely adore this scent. It's like me and a candle. It's just everything I want out of a scented candle.
But because the hairline of this wig is quite round, I do feel it makes me look a little bit like an egg. However, it was Easter just very recently, so I guess we could consider it convenient timing.
It's absolutely beautiful, very ostentatious, branded embossment on the front of it. Again, we are dealing with luxury. I purchased these directly from the Theatre d'Or store on Chiltern Street in Marylebone. For approximately, I believe at the time, it was either £70 or £73 each.
It also looks quite late Victorian, sort of 1830s onwards to about 1890s. Marvellous time. None of you are old enough to remember it.
And I'll confess, a sale is not only enjoyable, but very convenient. Only fools enjoy paying full price for anything.
I'm, of course, a complete and utter novice to the practice of wig wearing. All you people that wear wigs all the time, I salute you because I am
dying under this thing. It feels like I've got a stuffed animal on my head. In fact, I brought a fork along from the kitchen to sort of alleviate me from some of the severe itchiness that it is causing upon my scalp.
But the first collection, we had Velvet Morning, Velvet Ribbon, and Velvet Jazz. Then she launched the summer collection, which came in this turquoise pouch with slightly muted golden ribbons. With reddish tones aren't necessarily what I go for. I do tend to go for more nudes, as I do tend to find that reds or darker lipsticks make my chin look a little bit like a pickaxe, like something you would use to mine for diamonds.
Having a product disperses it everywhere. Stippling then corrects the texture. It's a very marvellous little trick.
These lipsticks not only look beautiful when worn, they are also aesthetically beautiful as they are. It almost feels like sacrilege to use them.
Digging it round into the socket, and I'm just swooping it over everything, just softening everything down, just to ensure... seamlessness.
You will be able to perceive I have removed half of the lipstick from my lips and a little bit of the lip liner, leaving a tiny bit of the lip liner at the outer peripheral of the lips.
Half the time when I'm getting ready, I'm there thinking, oh, Jesus, Mary, and all the blessing saints, what on earth have I done? And then as soon as you get the final things done, it all makes sense. Life all of a sudden makes sense.
Velvet mist to the lips, just so that you can see the colour. It's an absolutely beautiful colour. It almost gives the lips a look as if though you've been eating berries, but not blueberries, cranberries, raspberries, and maybe a little bit of beetroot. It's a lovely, lovely colour.
The packaging is a very obvious and visible feature about this product. It definitely reminds me of many, many numerous different things. It reminds me of things from my childhood. It actually reminds me of Polly Pockets a little bit. It reminds me of many, many different types of architecture. I think it's just a fun and innovative way of packaging a concealer. The component is rather fascinating. I could wear these as earrings. I probably would wear them as earrings. And they would certainly be very conveniently placed if you needed a touch-up.
But before I close today's film, I'm going to go back in with some of my Roger Parfums Taif Oud and give myself a very hedonistically liberal coating of it. The wonderful thing about applying perfume to the collarbone area is that the scent begins to waft up during the day. I must also admit that waft is not a word I have ever liked, but it is applicable in this scenario. So that more or less completes this film. I have shared with you today products that I think are opulent and will assist you in self-indulgence, self-pampering, and self-nurture during the winter season, which can be so fatiguing in so many ways. I hope that you have found the tips, the techniques, and the demonstrations for which that I have shared within today's film to be either interesting, useful, helpful, or beneficial. Once again, thank you so much for watching, and of course, take care. Bye!